Oh yes, this is Mike here, One Go ShortPlay, playing Bare Knuckle 2 on the Sega Mega Drive, Japanese version of Streets of Rage. We're going to see if we can spot any differences as we go along. Not that I'm going to notice if we do. Oh look, Japanese text, that's different. I know in particular, for me, this is where, well, Streets of Rage 2 is where the series peaked. Now, I hear in particular Streets of Rage 3 has other stuff in it that Bare Knuckle 3 has other stuff in it the Streets of Rage 3 doesn't have. I went Adam last time and he said slow, so I'm going to be Adam's brother this time, Sammy. That's not his name. Well, it is in this version. Okay, we call him Sammy. Skate's his name. Okay, so he should be pretty quick. See, already you can see massively graphic improvements. Again, a character I don't generally use, just because I don't find it very satisfying to use. I like being able to jump over the heads and fling them rather than do that. I like being able to throw them about. And Sammy doesn't know how to do that. Can you double tap on this one? You can. But how much nicer is this than the original to look at? Alright, Skeet's a bit weird in terms of how he moves. I would never normally use him. As I say, it's always Axel and Blaze for me. But we'll use a bit of Axel and Blaze when we get to Streets of Rage. As I said before, try some alternative characters this time. Throw the knife. Is it that to throw it? No. Oh, there it goes. Randomly throws it. Yes, that. I did get myself into a bit of a situation there. Lovely. Moving on. Yeah, not the best character to play with. I'm not a character I'm particularly familiar with. Oh, rats. But yeah, so you can see straight away Streets of Rage 2 has kind of got an energy that the first one doesn't. But you know, it's very much built on the same mechanics. It's really good fun. Oh, I hate those little dudes. When they've got a knife and they're running at you like that. Oh, they're just hard to deal with. You really have to catch them out. And they do generally catch you out. And that. Oh, that was revenge. It was a long time coming, that revenge. Right, let's go. Skate. I mean, Sammy. How nasty is this? He must be like 12, that kid. If that. And they're all, we've got like a gang of about 40 or 50 skinheads and punks ganging up on him. Their mothers must be really proud of them. Oh yeah. The dude with my eyes, he goes, whoa. I like his laugh. I love that, since my energy is pretty much gone. I'll let you off with that because your laugh's cool. But don't do it again, okay? Or there'll be consequences. I'll cut you up. Throw the knife, Skate. Sammy. Sammy. Since when was he called Sammy? That's the only difference I've found, to be honest, between this and the European Mega Drive version. There's probably more that I haven't seen. I love those little lights in the dark on that car. Just a nice little graphic touch. Ooh, you little... Come here. You have just been battered by a 12-year-old. I love the music in this game. Like weird jazz club music. Works really well though. Really suits the environment. That's the thing I didn't like about Streets of Rage 3, the music was just a bit of a dirge, you'll see with Bare Knuckle 3, I think. Unless the music in Bare Knuckle 3 is better than Streets of Rage 3, which I doubt, it's going to be the same, isn't it? But this music's awesome, it's got like melody and stuff, and it's it suits the environment it's in. You know? This track in particular, it feels almost of the scene, it feels almost diegetic. It sits right in, you know, there could be a band in the background playing this. A weird computerized synthesizer band. Nonetheless, but you know, it could be, you know. This is what could be playing in the venue. I think, actually, there is one situation in Streets of Rage 3, Bare Knuckle 3, sorry, well, definitely Streets of Rage 3, where the music is kind of diegetic, which is a disco scene where the lights are going nuts and the music's playing like a big massive disco-y, well, not disco-y, but like proper hardcore track, but it's really weird and nuts and the music is still crap. When you compare it to this, like in a minute you'll go outside and the music starts with rain pouring. It's just, you didn't have to do that. You could have just gone straight to the music. But the sound of the rain pouring is what you get first. And it really works. It adds so much sort of ambient sort of tension to the scene that follows. Which is basically a boss fight. You'll see it now when I've beaten down Electra here. I like that she pulls off her little cape as well. They didn't have to do that, you know, it's just like a little detail they didn't have to do. But to do it added charm. See, I want to throw her over there so I can use that space. Well, Skate can't do it. You have to dance around her. There we go, I'll do. There we go. Rainbow. How cool is that? Don't need to do that. And then when you get in there. Didn't really want to do that again. Oh, put the team. Oh, come on now. You big bullies. I love that they got like a boss tune, you know, for bosses. So you know that you're fighting, you know you're fighting a boss right now. And his little mates. Let's get that boss though. Hey, Skate's quite effective against that guy. Sammy's quite effective against that guy. I didn't know that. I've never been this effective against this boss. It's like clambering all over him. You usually end up getting thrown by him. If you try and throw him. Like that. That usually happens pretty much every time. He was surprisingly easier to beat than I remember him being. Could be because I'm fighting him with Skate stroke Sammy. Could be because it's Bare Knuckle 2 and not Streets of Rage 2. Oh, sorry, I was stretching and that's why I went all, sounded all funny. Could be either of the two. Either way, he was much easier than I remember him being. Again, Ace Music. With melody, well, you'll see. You'll have to trust me on that. How memorable is that tune, Steve? Well, it's not that memorable yet, but then it gets going. So. I don't know if it takes a throw the knife. I think you've just got to pull up or down or something. No. You've got to press jump and attack together. It's really difficult to throw knives, actually. Unnecessarily difficult. Anything that you've got to press two buttons together for on a Mega Drive game is a bit too difficult for me. Then again, I'm using an Xbox pad, so maybe that's where the problem is. Alright, and if I remember right, there's lots of holes on this level. How cool is that music? I love Streets of Rage music. Do they sell game soundtracks, I wonder? I'm sure of. Like, you know, the Streets of Rage 2 soundtrack will be an album worth having. Even sort of presents it as the Mega Drive music. Just chip music like this is. I think it is. Oh yeah. It's gotta be, hasn't it? Because Mega Drive only really good chip music. I suppose it had samples and that, but they were so, as you can hear from the voice sample, they're so cumbersome that the music, you couldn't really use them effectively in music, so it must be sort of chip music. But the soundtrack, even in chip music, will be ace, aren't they, Apple? Oh, come on. I'm never going to get that Apple, am I? Oh, I did. That showed you. But yeah, it'd be awesome, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it be? Get it on Amazon or something. Other music sellers are available. That'd be cool. I'm sure there are places you can get it. I'm sure there are places I've found that stuff before. But Streets of Rage in particular, or Bare Knuckle, I've not actually come across. weird biker dudes in tiger suits. I mean, what's not to like? Even the massive shoulder pads are cool. Oh, class. Sometimes you just get a move in that looks really stylish. It times itself really well. I am yet to do that at all on this go. Oh, I'll tell you what, I'm not going to get to be there. Because it's like over 10 minutes already. I'm having too much fun. Right, that was Bare Knuckle 2. Not much different to Streets of Rage 2, as far as I can tell. But hey, any excuse to play it again. Thanks for watching.